Hi everyone, in this video we're looking into applying a directional blur to our image. So in this particular scene we'll do the little trees in the foreground to make it look like our character's out of focus and that he's going rather fast. So the first step in applying any type of blur will always be to apply it to a bitmap layer. Right now, as per what we can see with the little gray strip over here, this is a vector layer. So we need to make sure that we convert that into a bitmap layer. And the best procedure for this will be to keep your original layer intact so that if you want to go back to it, add a few details, modify a few things, at least you'll have it in there to go back to and reconvert it later on. So I'm going to keep that vector layer and duplicate it using the little button at the bottom right corner of the layer view. So duplicating that, I have my duplicate right here. I'm going to deactivate the visual on the original layer and be working only from this one. So to convert it, I'll just right click on it and select convert to bitmap layer right here. And this will bring about this little dialog box. Because I have a fairly large image over here in this project, we are going to have to make the percentage quite a bit higher than normal. So I'm going to set it at 1200%, which makes for quite a large image. So this is because if the original point of your drawing is not included in there, your trees will get cropped outside of the frame. So you want to keep that large enough to include the entirety of your drawing. So 1200 over here. If I look at the image from the drawing, as we can see, this is quite a large frame, but enough to include those two little trees over there. So we'll be able to apply our blur from there. I'm going to right click on that image to go and apply the blur and go over to apply effect on bitmap layer, directional blur. So this brings up my dialog box for the directional blur. We have a few options over here, length, which will obviously be the length of my blur right here. I have the width, where we will have the thickness of our blur. I've got the angle right here. You don't have to necessarily go and punch in the number that we have over here. You can simply use the little dial over on the side here and it will write the number for you. So for me, I want the directional blur to kind of go in this direction here so I can leave it on that side. And I actually want it to blur in both directions, so I will keep the option bidirectional active for this one. So we're having our little check in the checkbox to blur the tree from both directions. So the fall off rate will basically be the distance where the blur fades from the edge of your image. So a larger number will generally tend to make the fall off closer to your image, while a smaller number will bring the blur much farther from your image. The number of iterations that we've got here is 1. This is the default number. So this is basically how many times will the blur apply itself to your image. So if you wanted to have smoother, nicer blurs that are, you know, applied to your shapes evenly. And also if you have things like colors inside of your storyboard or the thing specifically that you want to blur, to have a nicer, more even blur between those colors. So if you want to have multiple blurs applying, I would still suggest kind of keeping that number fairly low, because it is also going to take its toll on the how fast it is going to render out your blur. So 2 or 3 times would usually be just fine. You have to really try it out to see how it's going to look. So let's fill that up and let's try 500. Since I have a fairly large image, I'm going to try and keep it that way. The width won't really matter too much in my case. The angle we already have that kind of facing this direction here. I could adjust the number over here, and fall off rate, I wanted to be not too far from the tree here. So let's try a good 75 over here, and let's keep the number of iterations at 1. You'll notice I don't see right away the result. This is because I need to render it by pressing OK, but don't worry, we can always go back and really easily change it afterwards. So let's try it out, see what that gives us. So we have a nice subtle little blur here for when my character kind of goes past the trees. I might want to have something a little more extreme, so we can just do Control Z or Command Z on Mac to go back to before we applied our effect, and just go back here to modify the settings a little bit. So let's try changing the fall off to make it blurrier on both sides here, and give it a 25 perhaps, and let's see what that looks like. See, already that's a lot more extreme. We've got the directional taking place here, blurring on both sides. And since it's closer to 0, our falloff rate allows us to blur more extremely on either sides here. So this is how you apply a directional blur. Of course, you could apply it on multiple layers at the same time, as long as they are bitmap layers. Hope you found this useful, and I will see you guys next time.